How do we do the quantization in the n-dimensional case in general? So we choose n-dimensional reconstruction values, which we now call code words. And we use the nearest neighbor rule to map each n-dimensional signal vector to the nearest code vector. You could think of it as the neighborhood as n-dimensional spheres around each code vector. So each code vector has an index, and this index is then transmitted to the receiver, which uses the code vector as a reconstruction value. The collection of all code words is called a codebook. And the size of the codebook also determines how many bits are needed for their index. So usually codebooks are fixed, predefined, but there are also some cases which are adaptive codebooks, for instance in speech coding. And how do we obtain our codebook or our code vectors? So basically, like in the Lloyd-Max case, we're just extending it to the n-dimensional case. And for the n-dimensional case, this is called the Linda-Budzo-Gray algorithm. And it looks like the following. We initialize the iteration with a random assignment of m n-dimensional code words, y of k, it's a vector. Then using the code words, we compute the decision boundary b of k as the set of all points with equal distance between two reconstruction values, two code words. So then we're using the nearest neighbor rule. And such constructed regions, they are also called the Voronoi regions. Okay. To assign a vector to a specific region, we use the nearest neighbor rule directly. We simply test which code word is closest to the observed vector. Then the next step is using the PDF of our signal and the decision boundary, the Voronoi region, we compute new code words as centroids, center of mass, or the conditional expectation over the quantization areas, the Voronoi regions. So it's the same as in one dimensional, but here we the integral is going over n dimensional. Then we repeat, we go back to step two and we repeat it until it's sufficiently small, so it's smaller than a defined epsilon. So here we assume that we have a PDF of the signal. But observe that here we would need a multi-dimensional PDF or probability distribution, which is difficult to obtain since the volume of the space increases exponentially with its dimension, but the number of vectors rather decreases. Hence, we get less dense signal points in high-dimensional space, which means a PDF is very difficult to estimate. So what we can do, we need a different strategy, and instead of a multi-dimensional PDF, we often only have a so-called training set to obtain our codebook. So the training set is a set of signals which have statistics like our target signals, but which are only used to train our codebook vectors. So we use the Linda-Budzo-Gray algorithm to train using this training set. So to test the resulting vector quantizer, we should use signals which are not in the training set. We can still use the same algorithm as with the PDF, so we just have to compute the centroid or the conditional expectation in a different way. So assume if we have L samples in our Voronoi neighborhood region and we want to compute the centroid for this Voronoi region, we could do that by assigning each signal vector x of k of the training set a probability of 1 divided by L. So we assume each vector is equally likely, and then just use the above formula for the centroid, replacing the integrals by the sums. And this results in this equation here. So this is simply the average of all observed training vectors in our Voronoi region. The sum contains the indices I of signal vectors x of y, which are closest to the code vector k. So this is part of our iteration. After training the codebook with the training set, so we use only for training or to learning the codebook, we have a fixed codebook, which we can then use for encoding our data. So observe that the training set should be different from our data. The result vector quantizer could look like this image for dimension equals to 2. So where the blue lines are the boundaries of the Voronoi regions, so they're the B of K, and the red stars are the code vectors Y of K, and the green dots are the signal vectors.